ChargerLAB had made a charging review video of Google Pixel 7 Pro. This time we got the latest Google Pixel 8 Pro. It supports 30 watts while charging and passes Qi certification. To know the differences in charging performance of these two phones, we're going to do the wild and wireless charging tests of the Pixel 8 Pro. Open the box, here is the dual USB-C 3M cable. ChargerLAB Power ZKM003C shows it doesn't have any microchip, and there is a USB-C to USB-A adapter. It is used to make the USB-C charger compatible with the USB-A cable. The appearance has not changed much compared to the previous generation. Its 6.7 inches OLED display can support up to 1600 nits. It is equipped with a Tensor G3 processor and the Google AI. The battery capacity is 5050 mAh. The USB-C port can not only support 30 watts, but also support USB 3.2. The phone can also wirelessly reverse charge your headphones and phone at 5 watts. Next, let's test its charging compatibility. We used Google chargers and other third-party chargers during the test. It is compatible with PD and QC protocols, and the real-time power is about 9 volts, 2A, 20 watts. Among all the third-party chargers, only the Huawei 40 watts charger cannot charge it. It's also compatible with power banks and power stations. The power is about 18 to 22 watts, which is close to the iPhone. After that, take a look at its full charging performance. We use the Google 65 watts charger to fully charge the Google Pixel 8 Pro. The voltage is always around 9 volts. The charging curve can be divided into three parts. In the first part, the power was around 27 watts for the first 38 minutes, then the power drops to 12 watts. From the 52 minutes, the power drops to almost zero. But the power obviously fluctuates twice. It takes 1 hour and 36 minutes to be fully charged. We plot it into another curve to see the charging speed. It can be charged to 50% in 28 minutes and 80% in 46 minutes, and it reaches 100% in 1 hour and 36 minutes. The charging time is similar to that of the iPhone. Next, we put the phone into a 25 degrees Celsius thermal tank throughout the temperature test, and recorded the highest temperature on the front and back after charging for 10 minutes, 20 minutes, and 30 minutes. After 10 minutes, the maximum temperature on the front is 33 degrees Celsius, and the back is 33.6 degrees Celsius. After 20 minutes, the maximum temperature on the front slightly increases to 35.4 degrees Celsius, and the back is 36 degrees Celsius. After 30 minutes, the maximum temperature on the front is 36.4 degrees Celsius, and the back is 36.7 degrees Celsius. The power is always around 27 watts during the test, so the temperature increases as the charging time increases, and the temperature on the back is always higher than the front. The maximum temperature is about the same as your body temperature, so you won't feel hot to touch it. After the wireless charging, let's move to the wireless charging tests. We used a variety of wireless chargers from 5 watts to 50 watts. The real-time charging power ranges from 5 to 15 watts and is divided into fast and slow. The fast group is about 12 to 13 watts when charging with Vivo, Huawei, Basis wireless chargers, and the slow group is about 5 watts when charging with Apple MagSafe and Banks wireless chargers. Next, let's test how long it takes for the fast group and the slow group to fully charge the phone. Take the Vivo 50 watts wireless charging stand and Apple MagSafe charger as the example. First, let's see the slow group charging with Apple MagSafe charger. The voltage is always around 9 volts. The charging curve can be divided into three parts. In the first part, the power stayed at 5 watts for the first 6 minutes. Then the power rises to 6.2 watts until 5 hours and 7 minutes. And the power slowly drops to almost zero. It takes 5 hours and 32 minutes to be fully charged. From this chart, it can charge the Google Pixel 8 Pro to 50% in 2 hours and 41 minutes, and 80% in 4 hours and 17 minutes. It also reaches 100% in 5 hours and 32 minutes, which is very slow. Next, move to the fast group, charging with Vivo 50 watts wireless charging stand. The voltage is always around 12 watts, but fluctuates. The charging curve can be divided into three parts. In the first part, the power stayed at 7 watts for the first 4 minutes. Then the power rises to 14 watts until 2 hours and 1 minute. And the power slowly drops to almost zero. It takes 2 hours and 44 minutes to be fully charged. You can charge the Google Pixel 8 Pro to 50% in 1 hour and 12 minutes, and 80% in 1 hour and 54 minutes. It also reaches 100% in 2 hours and 44 minutes, which is much faster than the Apple MagSafe charger. During the full charging test, we also test the temperature after 1 hour of charging. With the Apple MagSafe charger, the maximum temperature on the back is 35.2 degrees Celsius. With the Vivo 50 watts wireless charging stand, the maximum temperature is 31.6 degrees Celsius. The temperature is lower than that of the MagSafe charger, and the charging power is about twice of the MagSafe charger. So the Vivo 50 watts wireless charging stand performs better. That's all charging tests for the Google Pixel 8 Pro. Its wired and wireless charging continue the performance of the previous generation and is compatible with PD, QC, Qi protocols. But the charging speed is not fast, almost the same as Apple. Since the wired charging is significantly faster than wireless charging, the wired charging is more recommended. But if you insist to charge it wirelessly, we recommend using a high-power wireless charger with the heat dissipation to ensure wireless charging speed. Okay, that's all for today's video. Please drop a like, leave your comments, and subscribe to us. See you next time. Bye!